Hi, this is Heidi from StoneGnome.com. I have this beautiful stitch pattern that I would like to show you. And I also have a little tip for you, a workaround. Because sometimes we have a nice stitch pattern and we have a nice right side. But then the left side might be with two big gaps. So let's look at the stitch pattern first. This stitch pattern is made from simple stitch and twisted simple stitch. And I hope you know this simple stitch. You insert the hook from right to left, yarn over and pull through. The twisted version is made in the other direction. And I like to use the lip or the nose of my hook. You insert the hook from left to right, like this, yarn over and pull through. There. That's all. So, simple stitch and twisted stitch. And one more. And the last one. The nature of this twisted stitch makes these gaps at the left of the work bigger than usual, and I don't like those gaps. So what I like to do is I insert my hook at the edge as normal. I like to find two bars here to insert into, like this. And usually for a back motion or a return, I would do yarn over and pull through one loop, but to avoid these gaps here, I yarn over and I pull through two loops immediately. And you can do it on all the rows, or you can just do it on the rows where you want to minimize the gap. And then I continue as usual, pulling through two loops all the way. Now I can see from my previous row that I started with a simple stitch. So I will do the opposite here. I will start with a twisted stitch, like this. And pulling it tight. And then I'll do simple stitch. And I'll do twisted stitch, and so on. Now I've worked almost three more rows, and I'm going to do the end of this row so you can see what it looks like. I'm doing a simple stitch and the twisted stitch, and I'm going to pull up my work a little bit here so I can find the last stitch. I hope you can see it. It's a simple stitch. Here, and then I'm going to find the side here, the edge, like that, and yarn over, pull through two stitches, and again and again and again. And to show you the difference, here in the top, it's the right side now, I Hope you can see the gaps are smaller now. We don't have that big gaps next to the edge. And personally, I like this solution a lot, and it might go well with other stitches, not only this stitch pattern. So if you have this issue in another stitch pattern, you can try this solution. Thank you very much for watching. Oh, I almost forgot. At my blog, you will find a few more details about this stitch pattern and the twisted stitch. And I would love if you like this video, subscribe to this channel, or put a comment below. If you have a question, I will also do my best to answer that. Until next time, have fun!